Hi there, Jana. Well, we know the Cook case is complicated and far from resolved, but we did want clarity on the NFL and its current take on domestic abuse. We talked to two men today, a lawyer and a professor. Both say the NFL has adopted a zero-tolerance policy when it comes to domestic abuse. They note the league has annual trainings and started a national program, but they also say there's still more the league can do.
The NFL once again finding itself in the headlines with words they'd rather avoid. But let's look more at what this case means for a league plagued by a history of high-profile domestic abuse allegations.
I will be surprised if he's playing the rest of the season.
Attorney Lee Hutton says it's clear the NFL personal conduct policy penalizes both criminal and ultimately civil complaints when it comes to alleged domestic abuse after their own league involved.
So what the new NFL policy suggests is that the NFL will investigate, and if there is any credible evidence to support her allegations, he will have to sit out either until the investigation's over or six games.
Okay, now big picture.
They are doing something, but they do less than they could do.
Dr. Oliver Williams with the University of Minnesota has worked in the field of domestic violence for decades, including even consulting the NFL. He says the league has made progress, but could go further.
I'd want to see them do more in terms of having relationships with battered programs, having relationships with battered women's organizations more directly. I think they should send them to a batters program.
And Williams would also like to see outreach that follows both the NFL employee and the victim.
I'd want to know what happens to the victim over time.
And as for whether athletes commit domestic abuse more often than the average citizen, Williams says there's just not enough data to say for sure. But he does believe the league could do more to deal with what's clearly a community crisis.
I would really like to see them put some money into trying to address the issue. I like the idea of going into the community to try to find how to create peaceful environments for young boys and girls.
Dr. Williams notes a big reason the NFL league hasn't made more changes to directly deal with alleged domestic abuse is the players' union. And this professor, again, a longtime voice in the fight against domestic violence. He does have a website, willtochange.org. That's the number 2change.org. You can find that link on our website, care11.com. Jana.
Well, certainly lots to talk about with this one. Thanks for that angle, Carla. We appreciate it.